We shall now understand the jQuery UI model dialog. The dialog as is made available to us by the jQuery. Once we understand it, then we'll go to add controls to it. So let us now see the UI model dialog as given to us by the jQuery website. This is the website jQueryUI.com, and here you'll find this is the model dialog, and here you'll find a number of examples. If we click on one example, then we see the corresponding source code associated with it, and this dialog is basic model, and we shall be using this dialog in our project. A quality of model dialog is that when it pops up, clicking on anything below is not possible. It will appear a slightly grayed out. This everything is done by jQuery. We only have to pop up the dialog. Now we should learn two things here. First is how to pop up. Second, how to set the content. Our content will contain the UI controls that will correspond to the editing dialog, editing form. For this, we can scroll downwards to see the source code, and let us do so. This is, we have scrolled down. This is the source code for this. So starting from here, this is the UI CSS file. This is the jQuery. This is the jQuery UI. And this is something internal for this particular web page. So we don't have to worry about this. These three are basically, we have already added through the bundles. So now we should come to the code here. The code here says function, so this is executed the moment this page is run. Generally this would be done through a click event or something like that. It says $#dialog-model.dialog, and two parameters are passed to it. #dialog-model means this ID. So to pop up this dialog, we should call the dialog function on this ID. This is the dialog function. It is called like this, $#whatever.dialog, bracket starts, bracket ends, curly brace starts, curly brace ends, and this is the semicolon. And here you are setting two properties. One is modal true. This is being set in JSON format. Doing this will throw this dialog as a pop-up. And by default, we should keep it hidden. How we can keep it hidden? By setting the style display none. They have already set it hidden because of this CSS file that they included here. We'll do it on our own. We'll add some code to this one there. There's no problem about it. And this is the content inside it. Adding the modal overlay, and this will be the title. Everything therefore boils down to just having a div with a suitable ID and a title, and its inner HTML, whatever you want to set, will be shown as the inner HTML of the dialog that pops up. And the popping up code is this. With this in mind, let us now proceed further. This is our index.cshtml page. What we shall be doing is, we have to show the order data on this page, and simultaneously an edit button here. When the user clicks this edit, now a pop-up has to come up. Therefore, the JavaScript code for this pop-up should be written on this page, and the div that will be shown as the pop-up will also be on this page. We'll first of all make arrangements for this pop-up. So here we can do, we create a div with id as dlg edit or dlg edit, we as we call it. Title is edit, it will display edit as the title box at the top. And then we write the scripting for this. Generally this dialog will pop up as a call of a function, as a result of a function call. So we are calling the function as show dialog. Before popping this dialog, we set its inner HTML as please wait, because the call is going to the server. Whenever you will be clicking that edit button, the form will be fetched from the server, and during that time its HTML will be displayed as please wait. Every time this function is called, its initial text would be please wait, and then that function would be called dollar hash dialog edit dot dialog, modal is true, width is auto, so that it sizes to the content. Resizable is false, so it will be of a fixed size because we have already set its width auto. And with this in place, our function for popping up the dialog is in place. Now we should add code for displaying the data for the whole of the TBL orders with the edit button there. So we'll do it like this. We'll now go to our home controller and send data to this page, and then we'll write the HTML for displaying that data. We should go to the home controller. We come here. Nothing is written here at present. We'll now start to write that code. Since we have to fill a drop down there, we can write a helper function for filling the view bag with the data for the drop down. Here we go. We'll call the function as get product codes using db and get the context. View bag dot product codes is equal to ctxt dot tbl product spaces. So it will return us the data for that table consisting of software S, mobile M, laptop L, and this will need a resolution. We can right click it, resolve. This one is resolved. Next we'll add information to this page, to this action method, to fetch the data for all the TBL orders. We'll query the context once again. And we have written return view ctxt dot tbl orders. ctxt dot tbl orders dot include tbl product space. This will bring the data for the related tbl product space also, and convert it into list and return it to the view. So basically our view will be getting TBL order, but each TBL order object will also get its associated TBL products base object. If this TBL order object is having a property for code foreign key followed by order ID followed by amount, then code foreign key will not be sufficient for us. We have to display laptop also, software also in proper language there. Data for this particular code FK from the TBL product space will also be attached. So this will come as two joined objects. One will contain this data, the other will contain code and product name. So if the code foreign key for this one is S, order ID is XYZ and amount is 1000, then an object called S software will also be attached to the TBL order. Now you will wonder, how is it attached? When TBL order model is created, it has a property. I am right clicking it, go to definition, and if you see this one, it has not only a property for ID, product code, order number, amount, but there is a property for TBL product base also. So that is attached as a property. If you don't write dot include there, then this will go as null. If you write include double quote TBL products base, then this object will also be created and attached as a property to this TBL order object that you are getting there. So there is nothing rocket science here, it is just a property. The entire table is one of the properties of this. And what will entire table, no, not the entire table, sorry, each record of that table. So one related record, each TBL order has a one related record backwards. That related record will be attached as an object of TBL product space. Still not clear? Let us go to the diagram. Here you see, this is TBL order. Each TBL order has got these four properties. In addition, there is a navigational property, which is also a property. And this property is TBL products base. And what do you see? This is 0 to 1. 0 to many. Sorry, 0 or 1 to many. So, one record here will have either one or none in the back link. So for each record, one or none will be associated. And we know that we have maintained all the proper relationships. So for this record, there will be one record backlink to this one. And that record will be packed as TBL product base. And we'll be able to fetch there in our view. We are passing to view but TBL order. TBL order consisting of these four properties plus one object of TBL product space. Okay. We have obtained the data from the table, passed it to the view. So when the user comes to this page, he should be first presented with the data. This data we have passed to the view, and now in our view, we'll come and draw the table. We have added the model at the top, I enumerable, because a collection is coming. Then we begin to write the table here. T head, product, order number, amount, edit for the AGX edit link button. After T head, a for each loop is used for each record. And why we have written id is equal to s underscore at the rate v dot id. This needs explanation. We need this id so that each tr record that is being shown in the table is identified later on. The id of the first one will be s underscore 1, s underscore 2, s underscore 3, and so on. We have just put s underscore so that it is not 1, 2, 3. You could have put any other prefix. Then, now we know when this edit button on this will be clicked, a pop-up will appear. And after the user makes his choices, a save button will be there. The moment he clicks save, this save call will go to the server. The server will return yes or false, like that it has accepted or rejected. If it sends accepted, then this has to go off. But this entire page is not posted. What we will have to do is we'll have to use jQuery to manually update the order number, software and the amount in the record in which this edit was clicked. So we have to have its ID available so that we can later use jQuery to search for these TRs and TDs and set up their internal HTML. Now remember, when it is AJAXing, there has to be a heavy dose of jQuery and JavaScript. And we should, in case of a table, we should always have its IDs, because jQuery will always work on an ID. This is to give an ID to the entire TR. Next. So here will be the product name, then order number, then amount, and then AJAX action limit, action link. This is the link button that will send an AJAX call to the server. And let us see the entire code, then we can discuss. This is what we have written. AJAX.actionLink. The first property is the display. So it will display that edit there. The second is AJAX edit. AJAX edit is the name of the action method on the server side, which will receive this request. We have to later create this action. This request will be get. So action for get. New ID is equal to @v.id. It will send that parameter int question mark ID. This ID will go into this. And lastly, we have to set the AJAX options. Method is get. Update target ID is delegEdit. So when the call will return from the server, it will bring the entire form filled in from there. We have to set the internal HTML, inner HTML of the DLG edit, which is by the time showing please wait. When the call will return from the server, this please wait will be replaced by the entire form with the save button that came from the server. That is why we written update target ID is DLG edit. And on begin is show dialog, the function we wrote just now. This function will pop up the dialog with the please wait there. A little bit complex, but when you're doing AJAX, then this manual story has to be done. And we are giving one pattern. This is like, I can repeat it again. This is your table. Started here, head tag, no problems. Then you have a for each loop. Then you have the for each loop. And inside it, we are giving an ID to the TR so that we can use jQuery to update it later on. @v.productName, order ID, displaying only the figures from the server. Action link, display as edit. Call receiver is AJAX edit on the server side. Parameter is this @v.id, the ID for the record that will be passed to the server so that this record can be searched there. New AJAX options get, update target ID is delegEdit. The please wait will be replaced by the form. On begin is show dialog. So with this, this form is complete. Let us run it and see what happens. This is the display that we get. And we have deliberately created a long form so that you can see how Ajax will prevent this crawling. Click on any edit. Please wait pops up, but it will continue to wait endlessly because there is no receiver on the server side. So in our next lecture, we will fit a receiver on the server side.